We are going to join another one of our New York affiliates, WABC, for their live coverage.
Plane overhead, and then all of a sudden I thought it sounded kind of louder. Then I looked up, and all of a sudden it smashed right dead into the center of the World Trade Center. Big flash of flame, fire coming out from all over. Then all the bricks is a huge hole right now. It almost looks like the plane probably went through. I'm not sure.
Winston, can you see? Are you on the north side there where the plane made contact?
Yes, I am.
Now, when you say a huge hole, one of our earlier witnesses, Libby Clark, said not much of the plane came down off the building. Much of it went
into the building.
It's in the building, that, from what you can see.
Right.
Now, can you see if there's a lot of debris downstairs, Winston?
No, because it looked like it inverted with the impact. Everything went inside the building.
Inside.
The only thing that came out was a little bit of the outside awning. But I'd say the hole is, let me just get a better look right now.
Okay, go ahead.
I'd say the hole takes about, looks like 6-7 floors were taken out. And there's more explosions right now. Hold on, people are running.
Hold on just a moment. We've got an explosion inside.
The building's exploding right now. You got people running up the street.
Okay.
Hold on, I'll tell you what's going on.
Okay, just put Winston on pause there for just a moment.
Okay, the whole building just exploded some more. The whole top part.
Okay.
The building's still intact. People are running up the streets. Am I still connected?
Winston, this would support probably what Libby and you both said, that perhaps the fuselage was in the building that would cause a second explosion such as that.
Well, that's what just happened then.
That certainly...
Yeah, people are running up.
We're getting word that perhaps...
Okay, hold on. The people here, everybody's panicking.
All right, Winston, let me put Winston on hold for just a moment.
Okay, I don't know how much longer we're staying. I'm inside of a diner right now.
Well, Winston, you know what? If you could give us a call back, I just don't want to panic here on the air. Let's just take some of our pictures from News Chopper 7. Now, one of our producers said perhaps a second plane was involved, and let's not even speculate to that point, but at least put it out there that perhaps that may have happened. The second explosion would certainly back the theory from a couple of eyewitnesses that the plane fuselage perhaps stayed in those upper buildings. Now, if you look at the second building, there are two, that both Twin Towers now are on fire. Now, this was not the case, am I correct, a couple of moments ago? This is the second Twin Tower now on fire, and we're going to check on the second flight if perhaps that had happened. This all began at about 8:48 this morning. Again, what we know, in case you're just joining us, a small plane, not a Cessna type or 5- or 6-seater, but instead perhaps a passenger flight, ran into the north side of the World Trade Center. As you can see, the second explosion that you're looking at now in the second Twin Tower, it has spread much debris, much more debris than the first explosion or the first accident. Is Winston still on the line with us? Okay, he's not there, but I'll just talk to my producer. Do we have an eyewitness that perhaps sees better than we do from these pictures? Again, you can see that there is debris falling off.
Come on, dip.
Okay, we actually have an Eyewitness News reporter, Dr. Jay Adlersberg, who is downtown at the time, and he is on the phone with us live. Dr. Jay, what can you tell us?
Hello, Steve. I'm actually uptown at 86th and Riverside. I can see the World Trade Center from about half the building up to the top. And about 5 minutes ago, as I was watching the smoke, a small plane, it looked like a propeller plane, came in from the west, and about 20 or 25 stories below the top of the center, it disappeared for a second and then exploded behind a water tower, so I couldn't tell whether it hit the building or not, but it was very visible that a plane had come in at a low altitude and appeared to crash into the World Trade Center.
Dr. J, we're going to take a look at videotape just moments ago of the second plane hitting the World Trade Center. That is spectacular pictures. I don't know if you could see the plane, and that too was a passenger plane. If perhaps some type of navigating system or some type of electronics would have put two planes into the World Trade Center within, it looks like, about 18 minutes of each other. You want to go to... We have another copy. There is the second plane, another passenger plane hitting the World Trade Center. These pictures are frightening indeed. These are just minutes between each other. So naturally, you will guess and you will speculate and perhaps ask the question, if some type of navigating equipment is awry, that two commuter planes would run into the World Trade Center's at the same time. Our director, you're speaking in my ear at this point. You are looking at live pictures right now of the World Trade Centers. Again, we now have two passenger planes within 18 minutes of each other smashing into the World Trade Centers. Dr. J, are you still with us on the phone?
I'm still with you, Steve.
Dr. J, this is just frightening pictures indeed, and I would assume... Or you would naturally think that when
you've been listening to some of the coverage provided for us by our affiliate WABC out of New York City, let's go now and check our other affiliate WNBC to get the latest. I'm sorry, WNYW here, live coverage here of this amazing picture we're getting from Lower Manhattan. Two planes, one hitting each of the Twin Towers at the World Trade Center.
They come by and they say, "What happened? What happened?" And you just got to say something hit the building, and then something hit both buildings.
Well, we saw clearly. We didn't see the first one, but we saw clearly that a plane deliberately crashed into one of the upper floors of the World Trade Center. That was the second plane. So, two planes crashed into the upper floors of each of the World Trade Center towers. And I'm just—I understand now that Port Authority headquarters are in one of those buildings somewhere near that location.
Jim, I don't know whether we've confirmed that this was an aircraft, or to be more specific, some people said they thought they saw a missile. Well, I don't know how people could differentiate, but we might keep open the possibility that this was a missile attack on these buildings.
Ali, I must say that we have an eyewitness who said it was a large plane that crashed first. And then as we were watching the live picture here in the studio, we saw a plane crash into the other tower of the World Trade Center. And again, let's just to be sure, there it is. There it is. The plane went right through the other tower of the World Trade Center.
That is a very hard thing to watch.
And clearly,
these are incredible pictures that we're watching this morning. These, thanks to our affiliate WNYW in New York. You are looking at this picture. It is the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center, both of them being damaged by impacts from planes. We saw one happen at about maybe 9 minutes before the top of the hour. And just moments ago, so maybe 18 minutes after the first impact, the second tower was impacted by another passenger plane. In fact, we've got some tape replay of that. Do we have the tape available right now? Here's the plate. Here is the tape. You see the plane coming in from what looks like the east side, and it blows into the building with the flames and the smoke billowing out the other side of the tower. It's hard for me to tell exactly which is the north side and which is the south side, but it appears it's coming out of the north side there. Incredible pictures. These happened just moments ago. And I believe we have someone with us on the line, Ira Fermer. We have Ira Fermer, the former NTSB spokesman, and you're watching these pictures as well with us, are you not?
Yeah, I'm with you on CNN.
What can you make of what we have seen, and particularly with this replay we just saw moments ago?
That's absolutely inexplicable. There shouldn't be any aircraft in that area, much less something heading with looked like deliberately for the World Trade Center tower.
You don't think there's any way this could be any kind of an accident, no kind of a navigational equipment failure or some sort of a navigational quirk by beacons or whatever?
No, you've got incredibly good visibility at this point, and no pilot is going to be relying on navigational equipment in such a circumstance that would cause them to crash into the World Trade Center.
How far out of the way from an approach to either LaGuardia or Kennedy would a plane have to be to hit the World Trade Center?
There are approaches that come up along the Hudson River, which is to the west of the World Trade Center, and those aircraft usually wind up going into LaGuardia. So you can come within a mile or two of the World Trade Center, but it it is such a visible object as you're approaching New York City that it's just not possible for a pilot during the daytime to have taken a course that would put it right into the World Trade Center. And a second occurrence within a few minutes is beyond belief.
And as you can see, there definitely is no weather problem, so weather would be definitely ruled out as a factor in this case.
Yes, the course is a normal course. I mean, for commercial pilots coming into New York, it certainly appeared from the video on CNN that the second aircraft was heading for the tower and that it was a commercial-sized aircraft.
Could you tell, have a better idea about what size that plane was? It was kind of hard for me to tell. You're an expert in these matters. Could you look at that tape and tell what size that plane was?
It would have to be slowed down, and you'd need more than one angle for it because you'd want to see how many engines on it, the shape of the tail.
Well, if it's possible, gang, could we go ahead and replay that tape right now? Do we have the tape ready of the second plane impacting? We're going to put that tape on in just a second. Here, we're about to roll it now. If you can, sir, I don't want you to speculate, but if you can, give us an idea of what you think might be at play here. What kind of plane we're talking about, or at least what size, if we're talking about one that would hold, say, 100 people, one that would hold 300 people, from what you see. You know, we'll have to back the tape up further than that, guys. Here we go.
Very hard to get a perspective on it. I don't know how far away we are at this, but that looks to me like it could be certainly a passenger jet and one of those aircraft that could hold 100 or more people. I caution you at this point to wonder whether or not that airplane was occupied by more than just a pilot or crew. We don't necessarily know that there were any passengers aboard that airplane.
Understood.
Darren Kagan joining the conversation here, sir, but there's no indication that there would be any air traffic on purpose in the area of the World Trade Center at this time of day, or any time of day for that matter.
Well, not directly into the World Trade Center.
No, but even close to it.
You would be clearing the World Trade Center by a few miles. Normal operations. And when you're looking at the pictures that you see with all this smoke and fire and all that, it's just absolutely unbelievable to think that a flight crew that wouldn't ordinarily see the World Trade Center, wouldn't ordinarily be on course, would now not see this as a flaming beacon to avoid.
Let me ask you this about the airspace. Given that it appears that two different airplanes have flown into the World Trade Center in 18 minutes, is it possible to shut down that airspace and keep another plane from doing something just like it?
I don't think that this represents an accident, and so I don't think that we're talking about having to now keep other aircraft away. This picture that CNN is broadcasting live is probably from the range of a couple of miles away, and you can see that.
No, certainly that, but if there was somebody who intentionally was trying to do the same thing again, is there a way to shut down the airspace to keep planes out?
No, you can't shut down airspace. There's no gate, there's no fence in airspace. All you can do is broadcast that airspace is closed, but if someone is intent on breaking through it, that happens with our military airspace all the time off the coast.
I want to bring up a couple of points right now, if I may. We have just been told that President Bush has been informed of this incredible tragedy happening in New York. He did have an event scheduled at 9:30 this morning, which we were going to cover here. He has just canceled that event. We expect he will probably have some comments fairly soon, and we will bring those to you live the moment that we understand he is available. But I'd like to ask you once again, Ira, if I can get back to asking you about this particular crash. Is it possible that those who are tracking planes, either at LaGuardia through the radar, can I give us some more information about exactly what happened here? If were these planes, I guess, using beacons to come in, or if there's some sort of identification of these planes as they approach the New York area?
Yes, there should be, if they were under air traffic control. You've got one eyewitness telling you that the first aircraft flew from Westchester and flew down through Manhattan and directly into the World Trade Center, presumably the North Tower. And now you've got, you're showing the other aircraft coming in, looks to me like it would be from the west, into the other tower. Those planes could be, should be, normally would be under air traffic control, but It is also entirely possible for aircraft to fly into, through, or over New York, or in this case into a building in New York, without being under the control, and we use that word advisedly. All that means is information is what air traffic control is, and just operate and do whatever they want if they don't follow the rules of air traffic control.
Ira Furman, we thank you very, very much for your insight, and the longer we talk, the less convinced many will become that this was an accident. We thank you very much for your insight.
More information on that just ahead. Now we want to bring in Todd Harris. Todd, on the scene, saw what happened. Todd, are you with us?
Yes, I had a perfect view, and the plane was coming in. I noticed it a second before it hit the building. It looked like it was moving slowly, and it lined itself up to hit the building directly.
Are you talking about the first plane or the second
plane? The first plane.
And Todd, tell us exactly where you are, where you had this great view.
I was on Highway 278, like a dead-on view of the side that it hit the building.
All right, Todd, hang on. We're going to continue our conversation. Leon has something to get jump in here with.
Yes, I'm checking the wires even as we speak. The Associated Press is reporting right now that the FBI in Washington is investigating reports that these two plane crashes are the result of foul play. There is a report here by the Associated Press of a possible plane hijacking. They don't say two, but they say a possible plane hijacking. Let's go to Kelly Arena, who's on the phone right now from Washington. Kelly? Hello, Kelly. Kelly Arena, are you there? Kelly Arena.
Kelly,
what have you learned?
Okay, well, an FBI official has just told CNN that they are investigating, but they have not yet determined whether or not this was indeed a terrorist act. The official that I spoke to said that so far there has been no communication, no one claiming responsibility for either of those crashes. There is an investigation underway. If there is anything to be said officially, it will come out of the New York City field office of the FBI, which is right now involved in that investigation to find out whether or not it was. But I have to tell you, I repeat, right now the FBI has not determined whether or not this is a terrorist act, although they are investigating.
All right. Thank you very much, Kelly Arena. We appreciate that. Darren,
let's go. Yeah, let's go ahead and bring back in Todd Harris. Todd, are you still with us? We don't have Todd. Okay, once again, if you're just joining us, the breaking story that we're following out of New York City, within the span of 18 minutes, two separate planes crashing into the World Trade Center. The rescue operations underway, not clear. We're going to show you, this is the second plane after the first tower was already on fire. This happened just minutes ago. We'll let the pictures tell the story. You saw it live here on CNN as it happened. The plane crashed right into the side of the World Trade Center, causing a huge explosion. Now, as we speak, and we're showing you live pictures now, smoke and fire taking place in both towers of the World Trade Center.
And it appeared that second plane that we actually did have on videotape on its approach toward that tower actually turned. And I have to think, I'm not an expert in these things, so I don't know, but it would seem as though that move actually may have caused much more damage. These are incredible pictures, as you can see here.
Let's keep the pictures up as we go ahead and talk to more eyewitnesses. Joe Trachtenberg joining us on the phone. Joe, are you with us?
Yes, I am.
Can you tell us what your vantage point is and what you've seen so far?
I heard on the radio that one of the towers was on fire, and we went to a high point in our building, which is on the 25th floor, and you had a clear view of the both World Trade Centers, and the one tower was smoking hard. And there was another plane that was flying low, and we just looked at it, and before you know it, just kamikaze, boom, right into the other tower, and mass explosion, windows flying. It was horrible. I'm still distraught looking at it.
Were you close enough to see or get a general idea of what kind of plane that was that flew in the second time?
Well, I'm not an expert on planes, but it wasn't didn't seem like a big passenger jet. It was a smaller type plane because it made some pretty radical turn, and you know, they were flying low, and you're not used to see big planes flying over Manhattan because I don't think you're allowed to, but it was pretty tough.
And explain to me again where your vantage point is, where you are in the city looking at this.
We're in Chelsea. It's 25th Street and 7th Avenue, and it's clear looking all the way downtown, and you could see the buildings, you know, the whole downtown, because it's a clear day, and it's a disaster.
And once again, describe for us what you saw as that plane went to the second building.
That plane just flew straight into the second building on the downtown side, it appeared. It was just a huge explosion. and smoke just immediately and fire started immediately coming from the second tower as it hit, and there was glass flying everywhere.
All right, looks like we have a little bit of audio problem with that, so I'm going to say thanks to Joe Trachtenberg for talking to us and telling us what he saw. We were watching it right here, live on CNN, as that plane went in. He had a closer vantage point and could see, as you heard Leon, he was saying he doesn't think it was a big jet, but a smaller plane, yeah, closer up from where he could see it.
Well, we do have a tape of a recounting by another witness, another eyewitness. We're going to go to some tape that we're getting from our affiliate WABC in New York, where they interviewed an eyewitness who saw the second crash as it happened.
I'd say the hole takes about, looks like 6-7 floors were taken out, and there's more explosions right now. Hold on, people are running.
Hold on just a moment. We've got an explosion inside.
The building's exploding right now. You got people running up the street.
Okay.
Hold on, I'll tell you what's going on.
Okay, just put Winston on pause there for just a moment.
Okay, the whole building just exploded some more. The whole top part.
Okay.
The building's still intact. People are running up the streets. Am I still connected?
Winston, this would support probably what Libby and you both said, that perhaps the fuselage was in the building that would cause a second explosion such as that.
Well, that's what just happened then.
That certainly...
Yeah, people are running up.
We're getting word that perhaps...
Okay, hold on. The people here everybody's panicking.
Keep in mind that the first plane hit about 8:48 a.m., so there had to already be a number of people at work inside the World Trade Center. We're going to go right now, bring in Rose Arce, one of our producers here at CNN. She's with us on the phone and has with her a number of people who have escaped the building. Rose.
Yes, there's a huge crowd, I'd say about hundreds of people on the streets that come from south to north. I've been really thousands of people that have been running from inside these buildings. You know, it's a very heavily trafficked area in downtown the World Trade Center. Many of them were inside the building when they felt the explosion. And they say there was just pandemonium. There was no warning, no alarms, no anything. Everyone just raced from their desks, ran downstairs, and now there's a steady stream of folks running away from the building. Some people saying that they're fearing there'll be another explosion, and when they saw the second plane, convinced that this was dangerous, there's just an absolute flood of folks escaping downtown Manhattan right now.
And, Rose, do you have anybody with you that could talk about being inside the World Trade Center when this happened?
Right now, honestly, there are scores of people that are literally running by me. There's debris on the base of the building that has continued to fall, as far as a block away from the building. And what's happened is that everyone seems to have figured out that there's ongoing danger, and there's just a stream of folks running as quickly as they can uptown away from this.
Understandably. What about rescue efforts? I would imagine there's still a number of people inside those buildings.
Well, right now what you see is there's trucks trying to get through, and people have actually jumped from the crowd and are trying to help direct traffic to try to get emergency vehicles there. There's no traffic going in the other direction, but because of the flow of people, it looks like some emergency vehicles are actually having trouble getting to the scene.
And from where you're standing, is there any kind of command center, any place that people are being directed toward?
Right now what there is there's a crush of emergency vehicles and rescue vehicles, but they don't seem to be quite organized in any direction. There's fire department vehicles on the one side where you see the smoke coming out of the building. On the other hand, you see groups of police officers trying to organize the crowd in a more orderly fashion. I think there seems to be some fear on their part that such a huge crowd of people might injure each other on the way out.
All right, Rose Arce on the ground there near the World Trade Center. We continue our coverage live with the live pictures as we go.
And we're just now getting word again from the Associated Press now saying that the crash of these two aircraft into the towers of the World Trade Center in New York appear to be an act of terrorism. This, they are quoting a U.S. official. They did not say which department of this this U.S. official was speaking from, or the authority this official was actually carrying at this particular point. But they're saying that a U.S. official is now saying to the Associated Press, he is saying at least, that these two aircraft crashes we've seen into each of the towers of the World Trade Center are the act of terrorism. We're just getting word now that President Bush is going to be coming out, and he's going to have comments momentarily. We understand we're keeping an eye on the picture from Sarasota. He's going to be returning to Washington almost immediately, we understand. Darren?
And in fact, as you mentioned, President Bush is in Florida today. We're supposed to have an education event just minutes from now. That has been canceled. Our Major Garrett is traveling with the president. Major, maybe you can tell us a little bit more on the president's immediate plans.
Good morning, Darren. President Bush, as you said, will make a statement here at Emma E. Booker Elementary School in Sarasota on the catastrophe at the Twin Towers in New York. Following that statement, the president will board Air Force One and return immediately to Washington. We are told by White House officials traveling with the president in Sarasota that he was notified either shortly before 9 a.m. or just shortly after. We don't have an exact moment of the notification of the president. We believe his chief of staff, Andrew Card, told him of the events in New York City. The president has been monitoring them as best as he can. He was, at one moment this morning, sitting reading a book to some of the elementary school children here as scheduled. Reporters asked him if he was aware of the situation in New York. He nodded a bit gravely and said he would have something to say about that shortly. We are expecting that statement any moment now. I can tell you here in Sarasota, with those traveling with the president, they are trying to sift through all of the amazing and terrifying both pictures and details as they can get them from New York City, but no confirmation here from White House officials about what this in fact is, whether it's accident or terrorism. They are trying to gather information as best they can, give it to the president, and trying to keep things on a very calm and even keel if possible.
And on that note, Major, it sounds like that exchange of questions with the president came at what would be a sensitive time if he was sitting in front of a bunch of school children and not wanting to scare the children.
Well, precisely. And the president has a way of letting reporters know that it's either an appropriate time or an inappropriate time to take questions. He does that in many different environments, many different situations. Clearly this morning with the crowd of children, he wanted to keep an even keel, keep the situation under control as best as possible. He just nodded and said, we'll talk about this later.
Right. So once again, we do expect to hear from the president soon, a time frame on that.
Within the next 10 minutes or so, again, things are very much in flux, things a bit confused. The event here, which was scheduled to talk about education reform, talk about the importance of reading, that has been scrubbed, and the president is trying to gather whatever information, all the information he can from various White House sources, make a statement, and then get aboard Air Force One, get back to Washington just as soon as he can.
Major Garrett traveling with the president in Sarasota, Florida. Major, thank you very much. And, of course, as soon as the president begins to speak, you'll see those comments live here on CNN.